Hey there, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we will be talking about congruent and similar figures. We've been using the word congruent a lot. Remember, congruent means exactly the same. And we've been using words like equilateral to talk about line segments that are the same length, and equal angular to talk about angles that are the same measure of degree. But we can apply the word congruent to entire shapes. When two figures are exactly the same size and shape, they are congruent. Looking at these two triangles, they are the same in every way. These two triangles are congruent. What about these two triangles? Are they congruent? Even though the triangles are oriented differently, we can still find that each line segment on the green triangle has a matching line segment on the blue triangle. So yes, these are congruent. And these two pentagons are congruent. We've just taken the orange pentagon and rotated it a little to the right. Shapes are congruent if they have the same shape and size, even if they've been rotated, flipped, or turned upside down. Now what about these two triangles? They are the same shape, right? Yes, but the pink triangle is obviously smaller than the green triangle. So these triangles are not congruent. When two figures are the same shape but different sizes, we say the shapes are similar. So these two triangles are similar. How would you identify these blue parallelograms? Are they the same shape and size? Yes. So we can say that these two shapes are congruent. Now what about the orange trapezoids? Are they the same shape and size? Well, they aren't the same size, but they are the same shape. So these aren't congruent. They are similar. But what about these two triangles? Are they the same size? No. Are they the same shape? Well, they're both triangles, but the big one is an equilateral triangle, and the small one is a right triangle. So these aren't even the same shape. These two figures are not congruent, and they are not similar. Now that we know the difference between congruent and similar figures, we can talk about the corresponding parts. Corresponding parts refer to the sides and angles that match on two congruent figures. We use this symbol, an equal sign with the squiggle on top, to represent corresponding and congruent sides and angles. Now let's name the corresponding parts on these two congruent triangles. Well, I see that line segment AB is the same as line segment DE, so I can write that as line segment AB, remember I put my line segment on top, is corresponding and congruent to line segment DE. Now, what other sides of these two triangles do you see are the same? They have the same hypotenuse here, this long side. So I can say line segment AC is congruent and corresponding to line segment DF. And lastly, I see that I have the same base here. So I can say line segment BC is congruent and corresponding to line segment EF. So now I've done all my line segments. What do you think about these angles? Yeah, so on congruent shapes, the angles are corresponding and also congruent. So we would have this small angle here on both will be the same. So we can say angle ACB is corresponding and congruent to angle DFE. Remember, I put my vertex in the center there. And I could say the same for all the rest of these angles. These angles will be corresponding and these angles will be corresponding. Nice job! Now, if we go back to similar figures, we know they are not the same size, but they are the same shape. So there has to be something corresponding about them. Even though the side lengths aren't congruent, they are different lengths, we can see which sides on one triangle correlate to the other. And it might be hard to see at first, but similar figures have matching angles as well. Here I have a red triangle inside of a blue triangle, and in this one too, a red triangle inside of a blue triangle. Now, what do you notice about the angles of the red triangle compared to the angles of the blue triangle if I change the size? Do you notice that the angles of the red triangle and the blue triangle are always matching? And notice that the side lengths of my blue triangle and my red triangle are always corresponding, even as the size of the red triangle changes. This means that they are similar figures. We use this symbol to represent corresponding sides on similar figures. So here on my two similar triangles, let's write the corresponding sides. So I see that AB, the base of my triangle here, will be corresponding to GH. So I can write line segment AB is corresponding but not congruent to line segment GH. What else? I see the bases. Those are going to be corresponding. So line segment BC is corresponding to line segment HI. See, I'm using my similar symbol here, not my congruent, because they're not the same length. And then I also see line segment AC is corresponding to GI. So I can say AC corresponding and similar to GI. Now, what about my angles here? So let's start with this small angle here. So I could say angle ACB is corresponding to this angle over here, and we know on similar figures they are congruent. So corresponding and congruent, I can use my other symbol to say that they're congruent to angle GIH. And I can say this for all angles. So this one here, I'm going to say angle ABC is congruent and corresponding to angle GHI. And lastly, my angles up here are corresponding and congruent. So I'm going to say angle BAC is corresponding and congruent to angle HGI. So once I can identify which sides of my similar triangles are corresponding, I can write these corresponding sides as ratios. Remember, a ratio is a fraction, and this fraction will help me compare the side lengths. So I could write AB is similar to GH as AB over line segment GH. And I can write this one here as BC over HI. And I'll write my other one over here, line segment AC over line segment GI. So now that I have my ratios, I can go ahead and plug in my side lengths here that I have. So for line segment AB, which is this one here, tells me that it's a length of 4, and that corresponding side GH here has a length of 2. And here I have BC, my base is a length of 6, and corresponding base is 3. And over here, my hypotenuse AC has a length of 8, and my corresponding has a length of 4. Now, what do you notice about all of these ratios here? I have 4 over 2, 6 over 3, and 8 over 4. All of these can be simplified, right? So 2 goes into 4 how many times? 2 times. 3 goes into 6 how many times? 2 times. And 8 goes into 4 how many times? 2 times. So notice that all of these ratios from our similar line segments are equal to 2. And that tells us that every side length on my ABC triangle is 2 times the side length of my GHI triangle. Nice work. We found that each of these ratios were equal. In fact, that is always true for similar figures. These ratios, or the ratio of the side lengths, are proportional. Proportional means corresponding in size or measure. And in math, proportional means a pair of equal ratios. So we can say the ratio of AB over GH is equal to line segment BC over HI is equal to line segment AC over GI. And we know that this is true because all of these were equal to 2. Now I can use this knowledge about proportional sides being equal for similar figures to find missing side lengths like this X here. So if I know that XY is corresponding to JK, I can say 10 over 5 is going to be equal to YZ, which corresponds to KL, will be 20 over 10, which is then equal to my hypotenuses, which are corresponding X over 15. Now I'm solving for my unknown value X. So if I simplify both of these proportions here, I'm going to get 10 over 5 and 20 over 10 are both equal to 2. And since I know that all these proportions are equal, I can say 2 is equal to X over 15. And now I'm just solving for my unknown value, X. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 15. And that'll give me 30 is equal to, I can cross out these 15s, X. So now I know that my missing value here is equal to 30. Good job. Great job learning the difference between congruent and similar figures. Practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.